You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
See if you can guess which dungeon this is.
That was a close one. I don't know, but this place is full of them. Everyone... Look, I'm getting out of here. Normally spiders make my skin crawl, but magic spiders?
Yeah, I'm just gonna race through here, sort of, kind of, because it's so dark.
Do not can't, spare them your blade.
Can't see anything. I'm just gonna go through from memory how to get through this place. Doesn't matter if I had a torch or not, the place was just too dark. Not negative lighting was used, but some hocus pocus was used, which prevented light from traveling anywhere in this dungeon. I want to say this is the fifth location now that I've found while using this current EMB. Somewhere in the notes it said if your dungeons are too dark, then use the ENB helper. But the ENB helper sort of basically puts your ENB in safe mode. And I don't want my ENB to be in safe mode. I want all the cool effects that the ENB can do. ENB helper is sort of it's legacy code for older ENBs that didn't have the true power that version 3.6.6 has and higher. And of course I've run into this thing again. I just keep pulling levers until it lets me in. I'm sure there's a mastermind kind of feedback from this mechanism that I'm supposed to be looking for. You know, like, two of them are right, but they're not in the right spot kind of thing. Or, you got the right idea, but you're wrong kind of thing. And, I hate puzzles. Not a fan of them. I don't have time to think, oh, this lever did this, and this lever did this, so therefore this lever should do this. Just open the goddamn thing. I mean, it doesn't change the story, it doesn't change how the output and input of the black box works. Everything in here is going to die. I'm going to get the thing out of the treasure chest. I don't know why. There's a puzzle lock on the gate here. At least it's not shooting me with poison every time I do the wrong thing. The fat net beards in the audience are probably thinking, oh, I love puzzle doors. They're the best part of Skyrim. Okay, it's gonna open soon, I can tell. I think I paused the game, or I paused Frap, so I didn't use up my hard drive filming this nonsense. You know, it never fails. It's all peaceful and quiet outside, and I think, oh, this would be a good time to make a video for Skyrim. And the minute I fire up my Sony Vegas and start dubbing over stuff, every freaking car without a muffler decides to go racing up and down my street. Magic types. The college is bad enough. So I have to constantly pause, wait for the car to go by, start recording again. Because of white trash, rednecks, whatever you want to call it. Thank you. get it? Oh, it ran away. Okay, it's fighting the other spider, and it killed it. Now it's coming over here, I hope. Kill it, kill it. Kill the spider. What's my companion doing? I'm trying to film this in the dark and I'm not getting any help from anyone. Okay, so I need to kill something way far away from here. Oh, now you who shot at me? Oh, I see. I'm the only thing left for you to kill. Let's do this! Okay, let's get out of here. Yeah, this place has got some light, actually. I have a feeling that when I have a companion with me, they're set to brave and not foolhardy. They're set for cowardly and but brave. If that's such a thing. So oftentimes my companions just stay in the background. They don't want to fight. So I've got nothing to film for YouTube except me trying to get a decent camera shot in the dark of a fight that's not going to happen because my companion decides to hide behind me. I want them to be doing the fight. No, I've already done this game. How many times now? I've already killed all the things. How many times now? I want to see how. You know, in theory, every companion in Skyrim is supposed to be different. The way they act, the way they fight, if they fight, you know, that kind of thing. Let's see if this works. So, I'm just a glutton for punishment because I bring along someone with me and I have no... Because I want to see how they fight. So basically, I get what I ask for. An experiment. Experiments... I call them experiments that have gone bad. Not so great expectations. So I ended up having to come in and kill the things because I'm tired of waiting for my companions to do it. Okay, now I'm at the point where I guess the spiders won't attack us if they're in the cage, or I've got some sort of spider sense where spiders just won't attack me in general because I'm such a badass. The spiders bow before me kind of thing. I'm Spider King. Instead of Dova King, I'm Spider King.
Show them no mercy.
So in a previous video, I was telling about how I can't stand H.P. Lovecraft's writing style. So I thought I would try again using a different audiobook with a different reader, but that didn't help. The stories were still bland. No matter who read them. Ha! Found you! I mean, some of his stories have been made into movies because they're just good stories in general. I mean, they're made for movies. Easily adaptable to film, kind of thing. But the movies aren't scary. If anything, the stories are more like fables. You know, lessons to learn. Man versus supernature, you know, kind of thing. His stories tend to be man versus himself, man versus supernatural. man versus the unknown, you know, that kind of thing. Anyway, did I mention that this dungeon was going to be dark? Can't even see the walls in front of me. See, now I'm just reading all the junk. I got one more of these books I have to click still so I can get them translated and stuff. That was weird that Sky Trek has a book. When you read the book, it brings up the commands. Maybe that's for people that don't have an MCM thing. Or SKSE, one of the two. So instead of using a hotkey to bring up the command, you read the book to bring up the command. This is an actual maze. It's like, did I come? I came from that way, didn't I? Yeah, I came from that way. We've been here before. And yes, you can tell that my torch barely lights up anything. I have to be, you know, what, 2 feet away from something for my light to hit it. Sort of nonsense. Somewhere there's combat going on because I keep getting the buff. I'm trying to wear out my stamina to see if something else happens. And when I get buffed up, I'm watching to see if my stamina regenerates really fast, like I think it's supposed to. Somehow I lost my companion in all this drama. I don't think he can't be killed because he's part of a quest I'm doing. Once I get this video uploaded to YouTube, I think I'm gonna binge watch Venture Brothers Season 7, which I didn't know was out already on Amazon. What, 3 years ago, I bought Season 6? So it took 3 years for Good Soup, or whoever they are, to make a 7th season, and then it gets shown on TV at some weird hours of the day, and then eventually it comes out on digital media. Gosh. Insert it into my computer. Watch it on my SVGA monitor. Okay, what were we doing? I think I was just trying to find a way out of this place. And find my companion. Probably just standing there waiting for me to say, "Let's get moving. We should be heading back." In the next video, my companion turns into a werewolf. Because I've got the mod installed and I hardly ever use it. But to use the mod, it's best to have RDO installed so that then you can make your NPCs aggressive when they're a werewolf. and they actually go and kill things because they're a werewolf. Man, I'm way off. Okay, I gotta go this way, turn this way, turn this way. It's a good thing they have maps in this stupid game. Okay, now where do I go? Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Up here, do this, do this. I mean, the exit's not that far away, but in the dark it just seems like it's farther.